Welcome, fans of Fate Grand Order. I am Avon, you're watching FGO Tips, and today we're talking about the second round of hunting quests for NA. I know I'm a little late. There was a lot going on in the US this week, so let's clean up our Halloween decorations and get right to hunting. This round of hunting quests will run from the night of Wednesday, November 7th, until the night of Tuesday, the 13th. Each day, one new quest will open up until we have seen all six. Each quest will have three difficulty levels, which will cost 30 AP, 35 AP, and 40 AP. If it's the same as last time, we can expect recommended levels of 50, 75, and 90 for the most expensive level. The first time you complete each one, you'll be awarded with 3, 4, and 5 mana prisms respectively. But these quests can be completed multiple times if you want, and they each have a reasonably high chance of dropping a particular ascension or skill material, along with skill gems and experience cards. On Thursday, we'll see the release of the Skeleton Hunt, with a high drop rate for evil bones. You can also pick up Lancer gems and experience cards here. At the highest difficulty level, you'll see 3 Lancers in the first round, around 20k HP, 3 more in the second round, around 30k HP, and a final 3 in the third round, 2 at 100k and the third at 300k. This one is going to be relatively straightforward. Fighting all Lancers means that Sabers are your best bet. I recommend at least one strong single target NP Saber to deal with the 300k Skeleton King, and at least one AoE NP Saber to finish off the wave. Rama gets bonus points for an NP that does extra damage to demonic enemies. No other classes will do quite as much damage and also benefit from damage resistance like Sabers. If you're lacking Sabers though, Ruler Martha is resistant and has a skill for bonus damage versus undead. Skahak has no class advantage but also has a skill for bonus damage versus undead. Unfortunately, Bones as a reward is a little bit underwhelming. Don't get me wrong, I do need Bones, but now that they're part of the daily rewards, it's not as hard to collect them. Not to mention the upcoming Christmas event rerun and the new Christmas event next month both include Bones in their lottery boxes. On Friday, we'll see the release of the Wyvern Hunt with a high drop rate for Dragon Fangs. You can also pick up Rider Gems and Experience Cards. In the first round, you'll see 3 Riders between 25 and 35k. In the second round, 3 Riders between 30 and 60k. And in the final round, 3 more Riders, the first 2 at 100k and the third at 250k. This is a tiny bit harder than the skeletons, mainly because we're fighting riders this time. The game hasn't given us many powerful assassins yet, and assassins are going to be your best bet. If possible, I'd bring at least one single target NP for the 250k Wyvern Tempest, and at least one AoE NP for the rest of the wave. I haven't successfully pulled a single gold assassin from the gacha yet, but free event servants, Shiki, and Skahak aren't bad for this purpose. In a pinch, you can even try Siegfried for his bonus damage to dragons, especially now that his rank up quest is available. Dragon fangs are another somewhat common material like bones. They are also going to appear in the lottery boxes during the Christmas event rerun, but not in the new Christmas event after that. Farm here if you really need them, but it's not something I'm going to stress about. On Saturday, we'll get the Golem Hunt, with a high drop rate for octuplet crystals. This hunt is also going to yield Berserker gems and experience cards. In the highest difficulty, you can expect 3 rounds of 3 Berserkers each. First round, 20 to 30k HP, second round, 30 to 70k HP, and in the third round, there's 2 with 100k and a third with 250k. This one leaves you with the most flexibility, I think. Berserkers are going to hurt no matter who is in your party, so I recommend ending the fight as quickly as possible. Bring your hardest hitting wave clearers, along with at least one powerful single target NP. If you want to farm, clearing this repeatedly will be a lot less boring if you can do it quick. Servants who can fill their NP bars, combined with CEs that let you start partially charged, will help you launch NPs on the first turn. For me, this means servants like Drake, Nidocris, Mordred, and Arash. If you're lower leveled and you're more worried about clearing the quest than clearing it quickly, you can also bring defensive servants to help out. Servants like Leonidas, Georgios, and Daon can taunt attacks away from your main damage dealers. So can Mosh, who can also provide defense up and invincibility. And servants like Media Lily and Ivory provide some of the best heals in the game. On Sunday comes the Soul Eater Hunt, with a high drop rate for Black Beast Grease. You can also find Proof of Hero here, along with gems and experience cards for Sabers and Assassins. The first round features three sabers at 30k HP each, while the second and final round features a single assassin enemy only with almost 450k HP. Since this fight only has two waves, farming might be a bit quicker as long as you can take down that boss as soon as possible. Single target offensive casters like Sanzang and Ilya work best for this, but AoEs like Ellie, Nursery Rhyme, Helena, Leonardo, and Marie help out as well. If you need more offensive power, Raiko's Mystic Slayer skill allows her to inflict bonus damage against demonic targets. If you're farming them quickly, there's not much to worry about here, but if it is taking you a little longer, just be aware that this assassin class enemy will only take 3 turns to fill its NP gauge. Monday brings the night round, with a high drop rate for Great Knight medals. Other drops include gems and experience cards for sabers, archers, and lancers. That's because we'll have to fight all 3 of them in this quest. In the first round, one of each around 20k. In the second round, one of each around 40k. And in the third round, one more of each. The saber and archer will have around 40k HP, but the lancer will be rocking a little more than 150k. This one is a bit of a pain, mostly because we're fighting 3 different classes at once. It's going to be harder to clear them super fast, because most servants won't be able to do great damage to all of them at once. Nightingale as a berserker does good damage, and has a skill to increase damage against humanoid enemies that helps out here. Unfortunately, her NP restores health instead of dealing damage, which is not ideal for farming. In addition to being humanoid, the knights here are also considered male. That means servants like Orion and Uriel have 2 bonuses against the sabers, and Summer Tamamo has 2 bonuses against the archers. Unfortunately, there aren't any male-hating sabers for us to use against the big bad lancer boss in the third wave. Luckily, 150k isn't too high, so even without class advantage, you can probably knock him out with male-haters like Tamamo, Maeve, or Stheno. On the final day of the event, we'll get the Demon Hunt, featuring a high drop rate for Hearts of the Foreign God. Other drops include the Fool's Chain, as well as gems and experience cards for both casters and berserkers. There's only 2 rounds here, and the first is against 3 berserkers with nearly 50k HP each. The second round is against 3 casters, 2 of which will have around 100k, and one of which will be much tougher with almost 350k. The berserkers in the first round have the potential to really hurt your front line, so I'd recommend taking them out in a single shot if you can. A number of servants can use a CE like the K-Scope and their own NP boosting skills to launch a Noble Phantasm on the first round, so pick one of yours that's AoE here. Arash is my favorite because after he's done, you can leave yourself with 3 fresh fighters for the final round. Against the Demon Casters, you'll probably want Riders if you can swing it. Try to pick those who can boost their own NP gauges and pair them with appropriate CEs so you can fire them off before the enemies even attack. Servants like Rider Kentoki can deal with the 350k boss, while others like Drake can clean up the rest of the wave with AoE NPs. If you can pull it off, try putting Maeve in the party and using her Golden Rule skill at the beginning of the fight. If you're lucky enough to have a full NP gauge by the time you fight the demons, you can benefit from class advantage, a powerful single target NP, and bonus damage to males all at once. If you're short on riders, try other servants with bonus damage to males, or servants who inflict bonus damage against demons, like Rama, Raiko, and Tawara. If everything goes well, you should be able to clear each of these fights in 3 rounds or less for optimal farming. More realistically though, they tend to take longer thanks to high HP counts, especially in the final rounds. Farm if you can, but don't stress yourself too much, or waste apples if you don't want to. Personally, I'd rather save them for Christmas. Still, I'm looking forward to picking up a few materials during the week and grabbing the mana prisms for completing everything at least once. Best of luck with your hunting, and as always, thanks for watching.